Good morning, Church family. So excited for this day. Thank you, Lord, that we're all here. Excited and anticipating what the Lord has for us today and being able to give praise and thanksgiving to God. So I just have a little thing I'm going to read and a couple of scriptures this morning, and then we'll get started. Looking forward with expectation to the time that we have together. All of us together and with the Lord, each one of us. So.
No, that's.
Thankfulness opens the door to my presence. Though I am always with you, I have gone to great measures to preserve your freedom of choice. I have placed a door between you and me, and I have empowered you to open or close the door. There are many ways to open it, but a grateful attitude is one of the most effective ways. Thankfulness is built on a substructure of trust. When thankful words stick in your throat, you need to check up on your foundation of trust. When thankfulness flows freely from your heart and lips, let your gratitude draw you closer to me. I want you to learn the art of giving thanks in all circumstances. See how many times you can thank me daily. This will awaken your awareness to a multitude of blessings. It will also cushion the impact of trials when they come against you. Practice my presence by practicing the discipline of thankfulness. And then I just want to read a scripture. Psalms 104:5, enter the gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name, for the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for being in this service today. Holy Spirit, we invite you here. Come into our hearts, Lord, come into our minds, that we would be totally focused on you today, Lord, and that nothing would interrupt that time. We set aside this time for you, just for you, Lord. And we ask that you would work on us and that you would allow our praises to be heard and that you would rejoice in what you hear. We love you and we praise you in this place. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. the nations, his marvelous deeds among the people. People, for great is the Lord, most worthy to be praised. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. at a potluck at Heritage Baptist Church in Bend 27 years ago. And they said, let's just start going out. And so they started going out and ministering to different churches on the road. And 4 years ago, I came on with them. Yeah, right after we were married, I came on with them. And the Lord just transitioned this ministry to be a time of worship and praise. So we played Long Back Train and some different songs that we're playing today because we want you to know we go into the prisons, we go into the homeless shelters, we go wherever the Lord leads us to go. And we have seen powerful, mighty things of the Lord, just amazing things that He has done. And how many years ago, Bethany, did you come on with us? From 2012. She's been with us from 2012. And Debbie, how many years now?
That long.
I'm
going to
say 14.
14 years. So she's been doing our sound and just praying for us and being our support for 14 years. But this ministry is not, and we're so glad to be home with this ministry, because sometimes we don't get to be home with this ministry because we travel the Pacific Northwest into Idaho, Northern California, that type of thing. And COVID kind of got us a little rusty, let's just say, because churches kind of shut down at that time. But our hearts for this ministry is that Jesus would be magnified and glorified, and people would come to know Him as their Savior, and that captives would be set free, that chains would be broken, that there would be freedom. And we are so blessed to have a family, a body of believers that support us and have supported us for years and years and years, to be able to go out, and our husbands and our children to let us go out and serve in this capacity. And this is an example of God doesn't use the best singers and the best instrumentalists and the best of whatever. He looks for a heart that's willing, and then He fills it. And because in our weaknesses, He is made strong. He's made strong where we are weak. And I will tell you what, after 20-something years, we've seen miracle after miracle after miracle, and people saved over and over and over again. So we come as humble servants to our family today to say we love you, thank you for your support, but the Lord is declaring in this place today freedom. From the very moment that we started praying in this building today, He's declaring freedom. And coming down to some of the songs that we're going to sing, and we've got some originals, but there is a declaration that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And He wants His children to be completely free, amen? So as you guys know, this Bethany over here, she's a very talented, gifted musician, songwriter. And this next song is one of the favorites that comes through when we go to the prisons or the homeless shelters, because it really ministers. And she wrote this song, and we want you to be blessed by it. Amen?
Let me cast my burdens away, and I
She's a blessing, and just praise God for her and her life. And so just thank you.
Good morning, and welcome to the spring. It's good to see you all. And for those that are not familiar with who I am, I'm Bethany. I was asked to share a little bit of my testimony. Don't go anywhere. And so I was preparing some stuff, and I was telling the girls, I don't think I have a lot to say. It's going to be like 3 minutes. But I thought maybe I would just share a little bit of a background of who I am. So I was born in Korea. I was adopted, and I came to the United States. And during that time, I went through a lot of different things, did a lot of traveling, and I was giving back to, I think I ended up in Oregon, and I was giving to Oregon as a ward of the state. And God was really gracious and faithful, and He brought a wonderful family into my life. My mom's here, and so is my sister and my brother-in-law, and then we call her Aunt Sue. Anyways, so they're all here, and my daughter, and so I became a daughter of Cheryl and Bruce Michael. And it's really funny because you should ask her to share some things because she had been wanting to have like a Korean child, and lo and behold, here I am. And he has an amazing sense of humor, and I think that this is just his way of like, oh, you're so not Korean, but let me give you a Korean butter. So, anyways, but that's just kind of like the backstory, and I could go into detail and stuff and just drag it out for ages. We don't have that kind of time. So, but the one thing when I was asking God what it was that He wanted me to talk about, and everything is, well, a couple weeks ago we had that wonderful pastor come and speak about running the race. And I've always loved that idea because in a race, even in a race in a track, you have your lane that you start out in, you know, and it's your job to run that race, and then it's your job to finish it. And then Abby came and she continued on with running the race, and it was just amazing. And so from the moment I was born to now, you know, God has given a word to me, and that is that He is steadfast, that He is the rock, you know, that we can look to, never changing. And then a moment came in my life where it felt cold. That being steadfast felt really cold. That, like a rock. you know, I was saying, God, I know that you're steadfast, but I feel like I need more than that. And He said, I am faithful. And steadfast and faithful. And it really spoke to my heart, just His faithfulness. In a world that is so unfaithful and so fickle, you know. So I felt that God's encouragement to you today, I'm like so shaky, so sorry, is stay the course. Mm-hmm. And keep running. And so, and that brought me back to, I've been struggling with getting my passport because I am not a U.S. citizen. I'm a Korean citizen, but I am legally able to be here. So no, I cannot be here. I finally have a little card to prove it too. But in Seattle, my kids are wonderful enough to go with me because they know that I do get lost sometimes. And I'm also, I hate driving. I finally convinced my son to go with me the last time because I said, I really like those car lights. we're using GPS everywhere. And so I realized I'm not a very straight walker. I don't know about any of you, but I leave when I walk. You know? And it's not because I'm frail or unsteady. Maybe last year that could have been my excuse, but it's not really my excuse now. But it's because I'm always distracted. You know, I'm always looking at things, or even if I've seen it before, but in this case it was Seattle. You know, I'm like, oh, this is the third time I've seen that alleyway. You know? And it was really frustrating for him, because as I was walking with Wyatt, he says, why do you keep bumping into me? And I told him, you know, I'm looking at buildings and street signs and making sure I don't get lost, because I am a great get loster. Even with GPS, I can go the wrong way because it never tells you where your arrow is pointed. So I always think that this is where my arrow is pointed until it recalculates and says that I was going the wrong way. So on the way back, I decided that I would watch exactly where I was going. And by doing that, I was going to look down at the ground. And I made sure I was picking my footsteps really carefully. And I didn't run into anybody until Wyatt says, oh my gosh, Mom, you totally cut those people off. So somehow my diligent focus to walk straighter, I didn't watch where I was going, and which didn't make sense to me. But I realized then that how I walk depends on what I'm focused on. And so my question today is, what are you focused on? So the first scripture that really popped into my head is Deuteronomy 6:6-8. And it says, and these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. So it's mind-boggling to say this, but it's been over a year since I became cancer-free. It's been such a short time, it's been a long time at the same time. And so thinking back on it, I am still amazed by everything that God has brought me through. And my focus, Kaylee? Keely, she is an amazing testament as well of everything that God has brought her through. And thank you to all of your prayers. You know, her tumor has shrunk down. Thank you, Jesus, with her being on the prayer tree and everything. Say hi when you see her. Sorry I didn't ask, but yeah, I pointed you out. So, everything that God has brought me through and every promise that He has spoken to me brought to the forefront of my mind. And His displays of compassion, His kindness and faithfulness through His words and through all of you, His people. Now, prior to being diagnosed with cancer, I remember thinking how important it was to remember the things that God has done for us. And the world is so distracted, and Satan wants us distracted. And he does not want us to focus on what God has for us, and what he'll do for us, or what he's doing for us, or any of that. He wants us to be weaving, I guess. and so I wrote a song called Together, and it references some of my favorite scriptures in the Bible. And it's also a declaration by me to deliberately choose what I focus on. And I thought what Debbie shared was so amazing, because it was about choosing to be thankful and choosing to, and what Natalie was talking about too. So that when I'm afraid and when I'm overwhelmed and when shadows come upon me and when I'm on top of the world, when I'm feeling great, when I feel like nothing can stop me, I will choose to remember God's promises. And I will choose to remember His words that He's given to me. And I will focus on all the things that God has brought me through. And I'm not going to focus on the trials and, I hate pokey things, and so I pick them out. But even after you pick it out, I was diagnosed with cancer, and the song that I had written became a question. Am I going to remember God's promises? Will I cry out his name? Will I choose to trust his words to me as true? I will admit that there were days that I did not want to sing this song. And I had to ask myself, what will I focus on? Because it's easy to get distracted. It's easy to forget everything God has done. But one thing I've learned throughout this time is that the more I focus on God, remembering his goodness, his actions, his promises, the easier it becomes to remember. And the easier it becomes to focus on that. So I have several scriptures that I want to share with you that have to do with this song I wrote. And I would like to just have you soak it in. And I'm sorry I didn't prepare anything. But the first one is Isaiah 43:1-7. But now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flames scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I gave Egypt for your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in your place. Since you were precious in my sight, you have been honored, and I have loved you. Therefore, I will give men for you and people for your life. Fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your descendants from the east and gather you from the west. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not keep them back. Bring my sons from afar and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I have created for my glory, I have formed him. Yes. Psalms 18:30, God's ways are perfect. All his promises are proven true. He is a shield to those who look to him for protection. In Psalms 23:4a, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. And Revelation 1:18 says, I am he who lives and was dead, and behold, I am alive. Amen. And I have the keys of Hades and of death. Joshua 1:9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. And Matthew 28:20b. And lo, I am with you always, even to the ends of the age. So as I sing this next song, I encourage you to think on the scriptures. They are God's promise. All of us that believe him. And then ask yourself, what words has God given to you? What circumstances and situations has he brought you through? Focus on these things and remember so that you can be encouraged by them and in turn encourage others.
You are mine, God.
Father, and where else should they be? So we lay them at your
their Jehovah Jireh. You are their provider, Father God. And we thank you for surrender, Lord, in the outlying cities that they will go into, Father God, that when their feet hit the dirt of that place, that the gates of hell tremble and Satan is defeated in that place, Father God. We just call it down in Jesus' name, that eyes would see, that the blind would see, and the deaf would hear, and the lame would walk again, Father God. So we just praise you, God, for that. Holy, holy, holy God. Praise you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord, protection on the water. Thank you for watching them during that time, Father God. We thank you for good seas, calm, still seas, Lord. I thank you for joy, that joy would overflow in them, Father God. Your joy, your perfect joy, Father, and that it would just spread all over that place. We praise you, God, for that. Thank you, Lord God. We humbly submit to your authority, to your headship, to your leadership, Father, that not one word would be spoken that is not of you, Father. Praise you, Lord God. And I thank you, God, that you remind us that you can raise the dead. You can raise the dead, God. You can cause legs to grow, Father. You literally can cause eyes to see that have not seen. And I thank you for great things. Thank you for great things, Lord. Praise you, Father. Holy, holy Lord God. Even on the planes, Father, as they travel, those are appointments. Whoever they sit next to, Father, whoever they come in contact with, Lord, those are appointments. Your will be done in that, Father. We just praise you, God, for that. Holy God, we thank you, we honor you, we glorify you, and we praise you, God, for these people. Watch over and keep them in Jesus' name. Amen.
I want you longer than a second, but can I get you guys to come back up here? Sorry, this is kind of spontaneous, but while we were praying over you guys, and Cindy was kind of motioning, you know, God does miracles still. That was a big part of the prayer. And so I just want to kind of open up this time at the end of the service that if there's anyone here that has any physical ailments today, or if there's anyone in this room that maybe is struggling with depression or suicidal thoughts or genuinely anything, guys, if you need prayer today, yeah. I want you guys to come up here today, and we've got our mission team here, and guys, I want you guys to have this opportunity, you know, pray over people. Also, if there's any prayer warriors sitting down right now, even if you're not going on this trip, you're a part of our team. And so anyone that has any prayer needs, please come up. And at this time, I want to kind of give this time to just pray for you guys. At the same time, this is the end of our service, so if you need to get out of here, it's not the end. Okay, never mind. But yeah, come on up. Yeah.
Like Jaden said, you can come on forward, and these guys can pray for you, but we're going to bring back an oldie but goodie right here.
Thank you. these prayers that are being prayed. We're fighting against what Satan comes against us, and the things that we experience can be make us feel that we've lost our ground. But we have not. We have not, and we have to go. One of the things that I really like about these next two songs that are coming up is that it is an active declaration that we have been given promises that God has given to us, and that we are going to go and declare that and take back what the enemy has taken from us, whether it's health, whether it's mental clarity, whether it's jobs, relationships, the things that the enemy has taken from us, they aren't his to keep, and he's not going to give them up easily. He's not going to sit there and be like, oh, I'll come and give it back to you. He's not. But we have that power in his name to take it back. And once we have taken it back, just to declare what he's done for us.
Thank you.
Jesus comes in and it brings peace and restoration and healing and wholeness. I love it. So we speak Jesus in this place.
Thank you. thank you guys for your attention and your time and worshiping with us right now with one song. This is a song that we wrote actually in the van on the way home from Idaho. And we haven't done it for a while. But it's powerful and it's freedom. And if you are feeling held in any sort of bondage,
strengthen them. You empower them. You give them authority, Father, to tread upon the head of the enemy. We praise you, God, for that. You are faithful, like Bethany spoke. And you are good. You are good, God. Children.